Welcome back, and I am now joined from our Perth studio by Ian Prentice. He is from Technology Metals Australia. And look, he's just come back from China, which we're going to get to, but we want to know what the latest is with that project you've got there over in WA.
Yeah, hi, Kai. Thanks for having us. A few weeks back now, we released our resource update, which was a very, very important part of the process for our definitive feasibility study. Really happy with the outcome from that resource update. Enhanced the quality of the resource. So we've now got 130 million tonnes at 0.9% V2O5 as our global resource. But importantly within that, we've now got a measured and indicated resource of 30 million tonnes at 0.9, which will be the basis of our feasibility study. But the bit that we really like about it all is we've got 71 million tonnes at 1.1% V2O5 as our high-grade resource within there. So that's a really, really nice number as far as, underpinning the longevity of the project, but also that grade. It's a really good guide to being a low-cost operator, which is where we need to be have that sort of 20-plus year mine life.
Yes, I was going to ask you about what those numbers mean, 1.1, where does that rank compared to other projects?
Yeah, so 1.1 puts us right up there as far as the pure play greenfields development project in the vanadium space. That's the highest grade going around. So that's a really, really key number. Some of the operators that are in the marketplace already are there or thereabouts. Largo out of Brazil have got a slightly higher grade resource that underpins their operation and their billion-dollar Canadian market cap. So that's obviously where we're aspiring to be. We want to be the next company to come along and develop a project at that scale with those sort of low costs, and that grade is really, really important for that.
Yeah, okay, so you've well progressed with your DFS. Can you just tell us what else should investors be looking out for in the near term?
Yeah, absolutely. So that resource, that's a key building block for the DFS, and as I say, the 30 million tonnes at 0.9 will be used for the mining side of the DFS and then support our mine life. But right now we're also doing large scale pilot plant testing. So we've got a bulk sample that we generated last year. That's just completed running through the front end pilot plant testing, so the crushing, milling, beneficiation. So that's been done, and we've generated our magnetic concentrates from that. Now we don't have the data around what the details of that yet, but that'll come in the next few weeks as far as what that magnetic concentrate looks like grade wise and recovery wise. But we'd expect it's in line with the previous work. Everything seems to be adding up there now. What the key part of the next step for that pilot plant testing is that sample is now on its way to the US, where we're going to do some continuous roasting test work. So really key at proving the scalability, upscaling our test work. So we're going to run that sample through a kiln up in the US, which really supports, as I say, the process flow sheet that we've got designed as part of the DFS. So that'll happen during May, and that's going to be a really key input into the study.
Okay, and just overall, how would you describe the vanadium market? Last year we did see, those Chinese reclassification of its rebar standards. It really saw the price shoot up and people were turning to niobium instead. How do you see the market right now?
Yeah, certainly. I think the prices we got to in the last quarter of 2018 were unsustainable. The key factor of the vanadium market, particularly in the steel industry, when you do get to that point, you do see a little bit of substitution and you do see a little bit of less consumption. So the vanadium market doesn't need prices that high. We don't need prices that high. Our pre-feasibility study was based on a $13 a pound long-term price. We've had that retracement, and we're now at levels that are there or thereabouts with the price we used in our pre-feasibility study, and that's a far more sustainable price. That's where the consumption side is more than happy. The users are more than happy to be buying vanadium and using it rather than niobium. Vanadium is a much better solution in steel than niobium. It's an economic situation. So at the point we're at the moment, it's a really good price point to support the continued consumption and growth in demand, and it also supports the development of projects like ours.
Okay, great. Ian Prentice from Technology Metals Australia, thank you very much for your time.
Thanks, Kai.